Tina Wilson was recovering from surgery while stationed in Japan when she went to the medical clinic for a dressing change.
He went from checking my lymph node here to grazing, and he put a good amount of his fingers went on my vagina to touch me, and he didn't even check the other side.
Wilson reported the Navy doctor, Lieutenant Commander Anthony L. Velasquez, the day after the incident in January 2008.
I was thinking, like, he just really just touched me. What if he's done this before? Or, you know, there's a little girl right behind me that's going to come see this guy next.
After 10 months, the investigation was closed with no action. Wilson left the Navy, distraught over the handling of her case.
It was the process that victimized me more than the day that he violated me. It was the process.
An Associated Press review of 1,000 military sex crime reports between 2005 and early 2013 in Japan, including Wilson's, revealed a pattern of chaotic and inconsistent judgments. Nearly two-thirds of the service members whose punishments were detailed in those reports were not jailed. Instead, they were fined, demoted, restricted to their bases, or removed from the military. 30 received letters of reprimand. In two rape cases, commanders overruled recommendations and dropped the charges instead.
How many more rapes do we have to endure to wait and see what reforms are needed?
Senator Kirsten Gillibrand of New York has been pushing to strip commanders of their authority in serious crimes.
They say today it will undermine good order discipline. Well, I've got something to tell the military. 26,000 cases of rape, sexual assault, and unwanted sexual contact a year is not good order and discipline.
It's a problem. We admit it. There are way too many sexual assaults happening.
But senior U.S. military leaders note progress is being made. 68% of cases were taken to courts-martial in 2012, with 238 service members convicted. That trend is not reflected in the Japan cases, home to the largest number of U.S. military personnel overseas. Out of 473 sexual assault allegations, only 24% ended up in courts-martial. 2 years after Wilson's case was closed, and after two dozen more women came forward, the Navy filed multiple counts of sexual misconduct against Anthony Velasquez. The final outcome, he was stripped of his medical license and forced out of the Navy. Time in the brig, a week. Tracy Brown, Associated Press.